Hi, I'm Cameron Smith, Junior Vice President. Thank you for tuning in to Student Council's March's Newscast. In honor of Women's History Month, we'll be recognizing some important women throughout history. First, we'll start with Ellen Cust. Ellen Cust was the first female veterinarian, graduating from the Royal College of Veterinary Surgeons.
Hi, I'm Anna Allendema, and next up for you, we have the latest updates.
Hi, I'm Mary Ellen DeFries with the Recent Updates Committee. First off, I want to remind everyone of some important spring testing dates. First of all, the SAT will take place on Tuesday, April 13th. The ACT Work Keys will take place on April 14th. And the M-STEP will take place on Thursday, April 15th. If you have any questions regarding testing, you can contact your counselor. Since March is Reading Month, my committee wanted to extend some book recommendations to you. First off, They Both Die at the End by Adam Silvera, Anthem by Ayn Rand, The Lifestyles of Gods and Monsters by Emily Robertson, I Know Why the Caged Bird Sings by Maya Angelou, and The Bell Jar by Sylvia Plath. Since March is also National Women's History Month, we wanted to recognize some inspirational women. First of all, Arabella Mansfield. She attended college during the U.S. Civil War, when colleges in America first began letting women attend college. In doing so, she graduated as valedictorian, and afterwards she moved to Iowa to teach at what is now known as Simpson College. There, she was encouraged to study law, and she ended up doing so and passing her bar exams with flying colors. This made her the first woman to become a lawyer in the entire world, which was a huge inspiration. However, she didn't end up practicing law. This was still an absolutely amazing feat for women. Next, Christina Hernandez. She attended California Polytechnic University for a degree in aerospace engineering, and she was later chosen to work at NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory in 2013 as a part of their Natural Space Environment Group. She was chosen because of the thesis she wrote on the debris and junk that is stuck in Earth's graveyard orbit. She was an engineer on NASA's Perseverance rover, where she designed an instrument to take close-up pictures of elements on Mars to look for signs of past microbial life. Currently, she's working on the latest Mars rover that is scheduled to launch sometime next year. Last, we have a quick environmental update regarding the state of monarch butterflies, courtesy of Maccabee Hootie Velasco's research. Okay. So the population of monarch butterflies in the west of the United States has plummeted. A recent winter count by the Exercise Society recorded fewer than 2,000 butterflies, as opposed to the tens of thousands that have been seen in the years past. Many monarch wintering sites in California and northern Mexico were empty this last year, leaving many heartbroken by the absence of these magnificent creatures. The drastic decline in their numbers is being linked to climate change, pesticide use, as well as the massive wildfires that swept across much of the West Coast, destroying thousands of miles of their habitats. Despite these extremely low numbers, the monarchs lack federal and state protections and are yet to even be labeled as endangered species. If you want to make a difference and help the butterflies, you can plant early blooming flowers and milkweed to aid monarchs in their path to other states. Thank you.
Hi everyone, I'm Sarah Tuskowski, and before we move on to the next segment, I want to tell you about Isabel Goodwin. Goodwin was initially a police matron, and eventually she became the first female police detective due to the success of going undercover as a maid and collecting evidence to arrest the suspect at the New York Police Department. Now moving on to tips of the day.
Hi, I'm Kaylee McMillan, Senior Class Vice President, here to share with you today's reading tip. When reading large sections, it'll be easier to feel motivated when you break the reading into smaller sections. Also, fun fact, on June 18, 1983, Sally Ride was the first woman in space and the first gay astronaut. She flew on the Space Shuttle Challenger. And that concludes today's tip and fun fact.
Hi everyone, it's Data Miner. Up next we have the Sports and Entertainment Committee coming to you with some more TV, movie, and music recommendations. Hope you enjoy.
Starting off with movies, we recommend The Fundamentals of Caring, based on the book of the same name. It follows a retired writer played by Paul Rudd, who becomes a caregiver to a disabled teen, and they embark on a 2-week road trip.
I'm not ready, Janet.
It's been 2.5 years. What's the magic number where you wake up and you're finally ready?
What's the thing you want to do most?
Hidden Figures is based on the true story of three African-American women and their role in the NASA program during the early 60s.
You have identification on?
We're just on our way to work at NASA, sir.
I had no idea they hired.
Captain Marvel follows Carol Danvers with the help of Nick Fury as she tries to uncover secrets of her past, all the while harnessing superpowers.
Truth be told, I was ready to hang it up till I met you today.
Moving on to TV shows, we recommend Gilmore Girls. It follows Lorelai and Rory Gilmore as they live in Stars Hollow. But yours is
better. You have a problem.
Rory, please put down that cup of coffee. You do not want to grow up to be like your mom.
Sorry. Too late.
Good Trouble follows Callie, Mariana, and their neighbors as they live in Los Angeles. Callie is clerking for a federal judge, while Mariana is working as a software engineer at a tech startup.
Yes.
We'll get you started on some data entry.
Data entry?
WandaVision follows Wanda Maximoff. After the events of Avengers Endgame, she and Vision are a happily married couple living in Westview.
Are you here to help us?
This is our home.
Then let's fight for it.
In honor of Women's History Month, we'd like to recommend Taylor Swift. Ariana Grande. And finally, Clairo.
Next up, we have interviews. But first, did you know that the first computer language was invented by a woman? Grace Murray Hopper invented the Common Business Oriented Language. She also invented the compiler, which turns written language into code.
This is Jaseel from the Sweden Newcast, and here we have Miss Sill.
Hi, I'm Miss Sill. I'm the swim coach and school counselor.
In honor of the Women's History Month, we would like to ask you about women who inspires you.
I love this question, first of all. I think who immediately comes to mind is my mom. So she has taught me a lot about how to be, what it means to be a strong woman, what it means to be independent, what it means to stand up for what you believe, and making sure you speak your mind. I've seen her do that my whole life, and so that's made it easy for me to learn how to do.
And thank you for watching on broadcast. I hope you guys all have a good day.